thin ice. Duck and Oliver were agitated. The winter weather had struck the coast, and their branch line felt the brunt of it. Snow piled high on the cliff sides, and ice glazed the rails. The engines had to ensure they had plenty of sand to stop their wheels from slipping. One morning, Oliver was bringing passengers to the big station. He was feeling pleased with himself. Too pleased, in fact. He hadn't realized he had no sand left, and when it came time to brake, his wheels spun helplessly. "Stop! Stop!" he groaned. Finally, with a sigh of relief, Oliver came to a halt. The passengers grumbled, while the coaches tittered quietly. Oliver was embarrassed. Then he heard more laughter. "Giving up your working life to become an ice dancer, are you?" There, in the car park, was Bulgy.
"I just ran out of sand," grumbled Oliver. "Nothing to get excited about."
"Ha!" sniffed Bulgy. "You were practically a runaway. You'd never catch me slipping on my roads. Your passengers would be much better off in my care." With that, Bulgy roared away. Oliver rolled his eyes. Now, Bulgy was trying to be on his best behavior. His collision with the bridge that summer had caused a great deal of trouble. The bus company had been quite clear that further lies and slip-ups would not be tolerated. Even so, Bulgy couldn't resist a chance to taunt the engines. Bulgy was on his way back to the bus depot and had to drive down a long country road. Contrary to his boasting to Oliver, he did need to be mindful. The roads were wrought with black ice. However, his sturdy tires gripped well, and he felt pleased.
"No slips from me," he chuckled.
Up ahead, Caroline was trundling slowly along.
Steady now," she mumbled anxiously.
Her tires were worn, and she was being extra careful. Before long, Bulgy came up behind her, honking angrily.
"Get a move on," he shouted.
"How rude," retorted Caroline. "Go around, you brute."
Bulgy didn't need telling twice. He swerved past Caroline when it happened. His tires hit a patch of black ice.
"Oh," he cried. "Help!"
But it was too late. Bulgy leaned and toppled off the road into a snowy ditch close to the railway.
"Ouch!" he wailed. "Please get help!"
"Oh, all right," sighed Caroline. "As soon as I get to the station."
Bulgy sighed. Knowing Caroline, that wouldn't be any time soon. He was most surprised when, not long after, Oliver arrived with the cranes.
"Oh dear," said Oliver. "Had a bit of a spill, Bulgy. Lucky you didn't have any passengers. I doubt they'd appreciate your ice dance routine."
Bulgy said nothing as Oliver pulled him back to the yard. The owner was waiting.
"Bulgy," he said sternly, "I demand an explanation."
Bulgy was suddenly very worried. He knew it was his fault.
It was that Caroline, sir," he stammered. She cut me off. I had to swerve to avoid crashing into her."
"She did not,"
interrupted Oliver.
"I was bringing my return train when you pulled your little maneuver. We saw you crash and brought the cranes as fast as we could."
Bulgy gulped. He'd been caught. The owner, red-faced, turned back to Bulgy.
"Aha! There you go, lying once again."
"Please, sir, give me another chance."
"Certainly not," interrupted the owner. "I've had more than enough of your fibs. It's clear you'll never learn. No repairs for you. You'll stay here until I figure out what to do with you. Good day.
The owner strode off, leaving everyone, even Oliver, at a loss for words. The winter months finally came to an end. The trains ran as usual, and Oliver had no more trouble with icy rails. And Bulgy? I'm afraid things only got worse. No one wanted a dishonest bus, and certainly not one in Bulgy's condition. Bulgy is certain he'll be back on the road in due time. But the hens pay no attention.
It's Thomas the Tank Engine, hip 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 hooray. Chugga chugga chug chug chuff chuff chuff, he rides along the way. And when you hear that whistle, it can only be one train. Our favorite little engine, Thomas is his name. With a heart that's big and strong, he chugga chugga chuff chuffs, working hard, helping everyone. Thomas, he has lots of friends, and you can be one too. Just clap, 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 and sing along. Thomas, we love you.